Welcome back to Suki Politics. Still with us is attorney Harry Roque. Also joining us now by telephone is the Volunteers Against Crime and Corruption, or the VACC. The chairman, along with the Ser family, launched a campaign today to raise a 2 million peso reward for the arrest of Senator Ping Lacson. To tell us more about it is the chairman of the VACC, Dante Menes. Good evening, sir. Thank you for joining us.
Good evening, dear.
Yes, can you tell us about that campaign that you began today? You're trying to raise money for a bounty?
Well, first of all, the DACC, after hearing that Secretary Lacson of the ANC had rejected the recommendation of the DOJ Secretary De Lima for 2 million reward for Senator Ping Lacson, initiated this morning and launched its fundraising campaign to have an equal amount of reward, so that this will help the law enforcement, help also the people, help those who might be having some information on Senator Ping Lacson's whereabouts, because it seems for 11 months this senator, who is supposed to be respecting the law, should turn himself in to the court, which he should be one of the rest, so that justice would be served on the victims, especially in the Sotobito families.
Mr. Jimenez, do you believe that Ping Lacson is guilty of the charges of having killed Bubi Dacer and the driver, Emmanuel Corbito?
Pardon?
Do you believe, sir, that Ping Lacson is guilty?
Well, there is a probable cause to indict him, and I think he was indicted wrongly, and he has to face the court. I firmly believe that with the evidence, the testimony of Colonel Cesar Mancao, he has to face these charges, and I firmly believe that he has something to do with it. You know, he was the chief of police at the time, and he was the head of the task force when Bobby Dacer and his driver were abducted.
So you believe, sir, that Ping Lacson should answer the charges based on the testimony of Cesar Mancao, even if Mr. Mancao's testimony had been changing?
No, I don't think that the statement or the testimony of Professor Mancao has been changing since he turned himself in. I firmly believe that with this, their motion for reconsideration has been rejected by the Court of Appeals for a wrong investigation. And so I believe that we have to honor the courts. And that's why we're wondering what the DIOG is playing a different kind of tune as compared to the DOJ Secretary De Lima's position that there should be a total campaign to not be pulled in the court. You know, whatever it is, one way to have the pressure to subject himself and turn himself to the court is to have this kind of reward. You know, this is not different from other rewards being subjected to other people who have been served in one of the arrests. If you recall, one of our members, attorney Camusita Castro, whose two sons were also murdered by this pandemic, you know, raised 5 million for the capture of the killer. And fortunately, you know, when this killer was, the suspect was found in Taiwan, in Bangkok. In this particular case, we were really surprised why Secretary Lacson did not even consider a fellow secretary, a fellow cabinet member, under the advice of his bounty. So
You don't believe that there should be a reinvestigation, sir? All right. Maraming salamat po, Mr. Dante Jimenez of the VACC. Thank you for joining us tonight. Okay, Harry, Attorney Harry Roque.
Well, I can't help but compare the evidence submitted here with the evidence, say, that we had on the Ampatuan massacre case. No? Mm-hmm. When we said there was probable cause in the Ampatuan massacre, we presented the death certificates of 57 of the victims. Mm-hmm. We presented eyewitness testimony.
And not just one.
Not just one. Oh. There were three. And mm-hmm. the three testimonies that corroborated each other that, in fact, it was Ampatuan, Unsay Ampatuan, no? Who gave the order to shoot and was one of the shooters. No? On top of that, we had at least three witnesses, no, that we have already presented who testified that all the Ampatuans were present in the meeting, no, mm-hmm. When they agreed to kill all members or all individuals who would accompany Mangundadato, no, when he files his certificate of canvas, no, his certificate of candidacy, I should say. No? Compare that here. There's a lone witness whose testimony is not even corroborated by the three other individuals allegedly in the same car. Mm-hmm. He didn't even witness the killing himself. It was simply a testimony that he overheard Ping Lacson using language which was not even certain, which he construed as an order to eliminate Bubi Dasir. No? Mm-hmm. To me, that's a world of a difference between probable cause when we file a complaint against Unsay Ampatuan, and when the Department of Justice filed probable cause against Ping Lacson. Yeah. And just my question is, why did it take them so long to file that, you know? Mm-hmm. They knew exactly where these individuals were in the U.S. They could have asked for their extradition earlier. But why did they have to do it on the 9th year of the 9-year term of Gloria Macapagal Arroyo? No? Mm-hmm. It was really as if someone just wanted to get even if she's no longer in power.
Mm-hmm. Okay, just a side question about the kanina sinabi mo, no, three other witnesses who did not corroborate the statement of Ses Mangkaw that there was that conversation in the car and he was in front, no. Is it possible, you know, some people kasi mga non-lawyers would think na eh syempre hindi naman nila aaminin yung conversation na yon.
Well, you see, that's the problem with preliminary investigations. You can't go beyond the statements of the witnesses. No? The driver said that it never happened because in the first place, it is impossible for Mangkaw to have been seated on the front seat because since time immemorial, it